Probably the biggest advance in breast cancer in the last 10 years has been the discovery of the effectiveness of a drug called Herceptin. This was developed and initially researched at UCLA by a physician, Dr. Dennis Slaman, and Herceptin has transformed the treatment of HER2-positive breast cancer in a sense that many, many patients are cured with chemotherapy regimens, including Herceptin, but unfortunately not all. In the past, HER2-positive breast cancer was one of the more aggressive kinds of breast cancer, and treatment with Herceptin has increased the cure rate of patients newly diagnosed with HER2-positive breast cancers. Unfortunately, not all patients are cured and will have a recurrence of HER2-positive breast cancer in bone, liver, lung, and unfortunately, often brain. HER2-positive breast cancers do have an increased incidence of brain metastasis, which obviously can be very difficult to treat. In patients with metastatic HER2-positive breast cancer, one would approach the treatment with some anti-HER2 drug. If the time between the initial therapy and the recurrence is over a year, one would generally go back to a Herceptin-based regimen, such as Herceptin plus Taxol, or Herceptin plus Navalbine, or any one of any combinations of anti-HER2 therapy. The other anti-HER2 drug that's available is a drug called Ticerb, which is an oral drug, which can also be quite effective in patients who have progressive metastatic disease on Herceptin. Some anti-HER2 therapy should be continued indefinitely in such patients, and various chemotherapy regimens can be used to treat the disease and hope to cause a response to the metastatic disease and therefore increase the patient's life expectancy. One of the most common and one of the most researched areas of breast cancer now is looking at a whole series of other anti-HER2 drugs. The two that probably will be coming on the market possibly in the next 6 months is a drug called pertuzumab and another drug called T-DM1. Both of these have had some excellent results in metastatic breast cancer, and once approved, will be available for such patients, and we would hope would further extend patients' lives who have metastatic HER2-positive disease. In addition, those drugs will start to be used in the adjuvant setting, possibly in combination with other anti-HER2 drugs, to increase the chance of cure and therefore decrease the incidence of metastatic disease.
Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.